Welcome back, students. Now today we are going to discuss about how to crack EMWTL in 10 days. Is it clear? EMWTL is nothing but electromagnetic waves and transmission line. So many students are going to think this subject is very difficult. But I will give an assurance that if you follow 10 days along with me, then definitely you will treat this subject an easy subject. Okay? And now one more very important point here. I'm going to start aptitude classes from September 1st, 2021. Is it clear? I'm going to start the aptitude classes. And now if you observe that this subject, electromagnetic waves and transmission line, I will give once again, I'm telling that I will give an assurance that you are going to crack this subject in 10 days. Okay. Just we are going to discuss about the important topics. Just if you observe that this is one of the important topic, pointing vector and pointing theorem. Pointing vector and pointing theorem. This is one important topic. Now we are going to see some of the important topics in 10 days. And definitely you are going to crack this subject in your external point of view. Is it clear? Now this subject, I hope that JNTU Anantapur and JNTU Hyderabad and JNTU Kakinada. Okay, these three universities, I hope that this subject is must and should for ECE students. Okay, but it may change the year, it may be a second year first semester subject, it may be a second year second semester subject depending upon the universities. Is it clear? But don't worry, the syllabus is common for any university. Is it clear? Now we are going to see pointing vector and pointing theorem. Just I'm going to give some definition of pointing vector and pointing theorem, and now from tomorrow onwards in 10 days we are going to crack this subject in your external point of view. Is it clear? Now if you observe that pointing vector, first of all if you see what is pointing vector and what is the statement of pointing theorem, we will see the proof in the next class onwards. Is it clear? Pointing vector is denoted by a letter P and the arrow upwards indicates that it is a vector. Pointing vector is defined as the cross product of or the curl of electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity. Is it clear? Now we know that the units of electric field intensity is volt per meter and the units of magnetic field intensity is ampere per meter. If you are doing the cross product here, then it becomes volt ampere per meter square. Then volt ampere is the unit of power. That means the units of pointing vector is nothing but watts per meter square. Once again, pointing vector is nothing but, it is defined as the curl of or the cross product of electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity. It is denoted by P and the units are watts per meter square. Now if you observe, what is pointing theorem? What pointing theorem states that? Now if you observe that, let us consider you are having a volume here. Indicates the volume with a letter V. This represents a volume and the power flowing in, and this indicates the power flowing out, the net power flowing out. Is it clear? Now according to the pointing theorem statement, according to the statement of pointing theorem, the net power flowing out of a given volume, the net power flowing out of a given volume is equals to the, now if you observe that this represents an energy, sorry, this represents electrical energy here and this represents magnetic energy. Therefore, I'm totally writing energy store and this represents, let us assume this is an ohmic losses. This represent an ohmic losses. Okay. Now, according to the statement of pointing theorem, the net power flowing out of a given volume is equals to the time rate of decrease of energy stored minus ohmic losses. Is it clear? This is the statement of pointing theorem. The net power flowing out of a given volume is equals to the time rate of energy stored within the volume minus ohmic losses. Is it clear? Here if you observe that energy stored, both electric and magnetic energy are present. What is the time rate of decrease? It indicates with minus d by dt. Is it clear? and minus ohmic losses. Is it clear? Thank you very much. Now from tomorrow onwards, we are going to see some of the important questions to crack electromagnetic waves and transmission line in 10 days. Is it clear? And one more important note, I'm going to start the aptitude classes from September 1st onwards. Is it okay? Thank you very much. Have a nice day.